A lot of things are changing because of what's happening with our environment, and all that plays a factor in how people's mental wellness is in the day-to-day and over time. And I think it's something we're not really measuring well yet when we talk about what is happening in terms of health impacts of climate change. Here in Cowichan, this river I'm standing next to here, the Cowichan Stalo, the Cowichan River, you know, it touches the lives of everyone who lives in this valley. And in the summer, especially this past summer, we had, for the first time ever, the river get to such a low level that we were pumping water out of Cowichan Lake to the river to keep it flowing so that it was a feasible environment for salmon to survive. And that affects so much economically, spiritually, recreationally for so many people in this valley. And so it's definitely showing some mental health effects. While we're having conversations about what we need in terms of new hospital beds or certain mental health programs, we really need to think about how we can also have programs and supported ways for people to get out into the environment, to get that connection to the land, to the water. What I know from being a public health physician is the lab work I work with is our population level data. And to really look at some of these impacts of climate change that we're seeing now, which I think is mainly some of the mental health impacts, we need to start measuring them, asking about them, and finding ways that we can help support them.